is new and old with 597. I wanted to start a series on working on the Ford Explorer. Well, obviously this is not the Ford Explorer. This is the Nissan. This was inside the garage here. I'm just going to close the hood, and we're gonna do a cold start on this old puppy, on this old girl. Got my assortment of keys. Well, we're gonna go ahead and do a cold start. We're gonna move this because the Ford Explorer is gonna be our project vehicle. This one, I'm gonna give you a quick update. It's been a while, of course. This one's on hold. It needs an exhaust. I had to cut the pipe out due to the exhaust, the muffler failed, it clogged up. So I gotta spend about $500 and get the whole entire exhaust redone. I'm in the process of doing that. Again, you know, lack of money, that's the main thing. But no reason why we can't start it up. And so right now it is basically straight piped. So it is basically straight piped. Alright, still does have the catalytic converter on it. But yeah, it's basically straight piped. Doesn't sound too bad, really. It's not very good in the... I can't talk today. Doesn't sound very good when you're really revving it, but it works. So we're going to go ahead and pull this one out. We'll let it warm up here for a minute. And then we'll do a cold start on the Ford Explorer, which has a bad alternator. Well, let's go over there and take a quick look at it. We can go and take a quick look at it while that one's warming up, I guess. This is a 94 Ford Explorer that I got recently. I got this probably a month... about a month ago. It's basically a 94 Ford Explorer XLT. It's got manual lock locking hubs. Four-wheel drive does work. It's got... Yeah, it's basically just your standard run-of-the-mill Ford Explorer. But the one thing that is different on it, which is... I mean, I suppose the two-door had this on it too, but this one's rarer because it's a four-door and it is a five-speed. Yes, a five-speed. So yeah, that a little bit more rare in this occasion. Again, it's not that bad, really. I've got some junk in it because I've been tearing it apart. But I mean, it's really not that bad. Headliner's not sagging. When I got it, it did need some work. Let's pop the hood and I'll show you what I've done to it. It did need some work when I bought it. The motor did run, but for lack of a better term, it ran like a goose and a duck. Well, let me grab this one second here, guys. So it ran like a goose and a duck. But it did run. So I went to Rock Auto. That's where I get most of my parts. And I installed new spark plug wires of Ford spark plug wires. I installed the motorcraft. And I also installed the motorcraft spark plug wires. And I installed I installed the Motorcraft spark plugs, and that got it back up and running just fine. And then I noticed the fan. It's actually got a whole new fan on it because the fan cracked. And since I had everything out, I had to drain everything. I went ahead and replaced the radiator. The cooling hoses were original. They were Motorcraft. So I had to replace that. And supposedly, this alternator is now failing. It's not keeping up on charge. And to be honest, it looks like the original alternator. So, previous owner changed the battery. It's got an AC Delco battery. Whatever, it works. I changed radiator, coolant hoses. Didn't change the two back ones back here. Because I just didn't need it. I didn't feel like taking it off. Eventually I may, but for right now there's no worries. It's not leaking. The AC was completely shot. I had to go through. Again, Rock Auto came to the rescue. Got a new evaporator. That was a pain in the neck to get undone. But I got it undone. Someone cracked the evaporator. The hose going out to the evaporator. I don't know exactly what happened, but somebody cracked it. So I changed that. Changed the accumulator. Put a new pressure switch on it. New compressor. Compressor was pre-filled with 8 ounces of oil, which for the new evaporator and the new compressor circulating through, that worked quite well. That worked actually quite well. Of course, we had to change. Of course, when I got it, the fan was completely blown. So I had to do the fan. So yeah, now the next step here, we got to do the alternator. It's broke. The headlight has failed. The headlight has failed, so we're going to do the headlight. I think we're just going to do both of them, which shouldn't be too bad, I don't think. So we're going to go ahead and do both headlights, and that must be the regulator. Must be the regulator right there. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Do the both headlights. Adjust them. They need to be, they're a little adjusted, a little bit funky. We're going to have to adjust them. But yeah, that's our project. That's what we're going to be working on. Parts is coming in for Rock Auto for the alternator. Of course, I got Rock Auto, I got the radiator. And I also coming in, also there's one more thing we're going to have to do to it eventually, is the manifold, exhaust manifold, is leaking. I mean, not the exhaust manifold, the valve cover gaskets are leaking right down there. It leaks a little bit of oil, so I did get a quart for that. We're probably going to have to take that undone. I'm going to assume so, because it's leaking. It's leaking pretty badly. So, and I believe we have to pull the manifold off to get to it. We're probably going to have to pull the EGR valve and, you know, a couple of these sensors. So we'll see. I've got vacuum lines here. I'm hoping I can just disconnect the vacuum lines. Just disconnect the vacuum lines. I'm hoping there. Just mark them. So, yeah, that's what we're going to do there. That's going to be down the road. It's still drivable. It doesn't leak too bad. It smells a little bit of oil every so often, but it's not too bad. But that's it for right now. So right now it's started up here while the Nissan's warming up. We'll start it up. Let this one warm up for a few minutes. We'll do a cold start. This was running yesterday, So I don't, it should start up just fine. Again, you know, starts up quite nicely. No problems. But again, you know, sounds good. Supposedly this was a two-owner vehicle. The guy I bought it from the original owner that I guess custom ordered it. We'll explain why it's a four-door with a five-speed. I've no reason not to believe him. Volvo's only got 137,000 miles on it. So, I don't know. I don't know. So, we'll see. I'm going to change the alternator. We'll let this warm up for a few minutes. So everything should look good. So let's go ahead and move the Nissan. We'll move the Nissan right here, I think. So let's go ahead and do that.